In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Quicken from a new file. You'll learn how to add your first accounts and how to reconcile transactions. This video is geared toward beginners. I'm using the yearly subscription of Quicken Home, Business, and Rental Property for this demo. If you are using a different version, the steps should be the same. Here's a tip. Don't be a slave to your spending. Use Quicken as a tool to learn where your money is going. Then, create a budget from that data. From the Quicken Home page, click Add Account. If you see your bank in the box, select it. If not, simply type it in the box and click Next. Click Sign In. Your web browser will open and take you to your bank sign-in page. Sign into your bank using your username and password. I use Bitwarden Password Safe. I highly recommend using a password safe for all of your passwords. It will help keep your online banking secure. I have another video showing how to use Bitwarden. Click Sign In. Now click Next. Click Next again. Choose the accounts you want to set up. You should be able to select them individually. Mine are already set up. Next, click Connect My Accounts. Now, minimize your browser and watch Quicken add the accounts. Here, you can select the account type, if it's not already correct. Here, you can add a nickname if you want to. Select what the account will be used for: personal, business, or rental property. I'm going to keep them all personal, since I'll set up my business and rental properties in another video. Be sure to watch for these. Now click Next. You can now see the new accounts here on the left pane. When you click on one, you can see the most recent transactions. This column shows the date of the transaction. You can add a check number in this column. Here you can change the payee if it is not correct. You can add a memo in this box. Categories are one of the most important things in Quicken. This is how the software builds your budget. You will want to get familiar with them. Here you can add a tag. I'll explain these in another video. Confirm this amount on your receipt. You will want to reconcile each of these amounts with your receipts. This one is a deposit from your employer. This one is a credit card payment. Reconcile each of these. In the next video, you will learn how to reconcile your credit card receipts. Please like and subscribe for more helpful tips.